Dear students, welcome back in today's lecture. You might have gone through my previous lecture in which I have explained you that how we have to use a psychometric chart and what properties we can get from it. And there were total 8 properties. Now in today's lecture, we will go through the processes which we have on psychometric chart itself, means psychometric process. If the air is heated without humidification, then it is called humidification or dehumidification. Then it is called sensible heating, means only temperature rises. The reverse is sensible cooling, the second process. And the third process is humidification and dehumidification. These are shown by the vertical line, and above 2 are shown by the horizontal line. I will explain you later. The third one is cooling and adiabatic humidification. In this, we have combined the two processes, means cooling plus humidification. And the fifth one is cooling and humidification by water injection. Sixth is humidification, heating and humidification. Seventh is humidification by steam injection. Eighth is adiabatic chemical dehumidification. And ninth is adiabatic mixing of air streams. The numericals and the either the numericals are asked on the 9th process or simple the processes are asked in the examination. How these processes are seen on the psychometric chart itself, I will explain you in this lecture itself, and one by one each and every process will be discussed with you. Now starting with the first process, that is sensible heating, and I am starting with the first process. Before starting any process, I would like to show you that how in psychometric chart, how these process used to look like. The basic concept of psychometric chart should be known to you also. For this, you should know that when we move on a psychometric chart, the temperature used to rise from minus 5 to 43 degrees centigrade, means the temperature is rising in this direction. Means if you move from this to this direction, the temperature will increase, and if we move from this to this direction, the temperature will decrease, because if you are cooling, then you have to move from 43 to minus 5, means opposite direction, and for heating you have to move in this direction. Similarly, for humidity also, if we are taking the humidity, if we are humidifying, then we have to move from bottom side to upper side, and if we are dehumidifying, then we have to move from upper side to the lower side. This should be known to you, that how these things are done. This is the basic concept. Now we are starting with the first process itself, that was mentioned to you. It was sensible heating. In sensible heating, what used to happen? Air used to enter and touch the coil, because it is a heating process. So these coils are called heating coils. And when it come out, this temperature get increased. This is being shown to you, that its temperature is increased, and this temperature is increased. This is being shown to you, the temperature get increased. The air is entering at slightly lower temperature, that is at T1, and when it touch the coils which are at higher temperature, the temperature get increased. This can be understood, can be explained by a example, that if the air is entering, if you are using means you are using heat pump device in winter season, the air outside is at 10 degree centigrade and you want a comfort air at 22 or 23 degree centigrade, then heating coil should be at higher temperature. It means the heating coil should be at temperature of 30 or 40 around. In this way, the first temperature will be the of air, the second will be of air coming out, and third will be of the heating coil itself. This process is called sensible heating because in this process there is no change in specific humidity. That's why these are shown by horizontal line. Similar to this, there is one other process also in which there is sensible cooling. In sensible cooling, what used to happen? The air is cooled. Means the air initially is at higher temperature. The temperature was high. And after cooling, its temperature get down. But the main thing is that the coil which it is touching, that coil is below, is a coolest one. means if the air outside in the summer season, the air temperature is 35 degree centigrade, which is entering the coil in the AC, and you are getting the cool air or comfort air at 22 degree centigrade, it means that the coil which it is touching would have been at lower temperature. It means it would have been at 13 or 14 degree centigrade, which is shown to you. The sensible cooling process is shown over here, and here you can see that the air is entering at temperature 1, and after cooling the exit air temperature is as T2, whereas the apparatus temperature means the coil temperature is at T3, that is below the 2 when we are cooling. The particular example can be explained through numerical also, means how this process is taking place. For this I have taken one numerical. In this it is written that, in this case it is written that a heating application, moist air enter at coils at 10 degree centigrade and 50% RH. Means what they have, what they are saying, means the moist air is entering at 10 degree centigrade and 50% RH and leaves at 30 degree centigrade. We know that we require two data to get a point. These two data are when the air is entering, means here is a heating process, the air is entering at 10 and 50% RH, means the 10 degree centigrade temperature you have to point out, and when it will touch the 50% relative humidity curve, you will get the first point. And you have to go for sensible heat transfer process, means you have to go horizontally in right hand side directions. Means if we plot this data on the, show this data on the psychrometric chart itself, how it can be shown. The 10 degree centigrade temperature they have shown over here, that what the temperature is. The temperature is 10 degree centigrade. And the relative humidity what they have mentioned is 50%. The 50% is shown to you over here. This is the 50% curve. And when it will touch the 10 degree centigrade line, then you will get the first point. From here you have to draw the horizontal line. It can be shown to you like this, that this is the 10 degree and somewhat the 50% curve was there. If we get the first point over here, then you have to draw a horizontal line from here up to 30 degree centigrade. You have to extend this line. This line is to be extended, and you have to draw it. You have to draw it up to 30 degree centigrade. Now at these two points, you will note down the enthalpies, what the enthalpies are. You will directly get the enthalpies at these two points. And by taking the difference of these two enthalpies, means H1 and H2. By taking the difference of these two enthalpies, H1 and H2, you will directly know that what heat transfer has taken place between the two stages. Well, this is the numerical they have shown over here, and I have discussed with you the numerical also, that the initial stage was 10 degree centigrade and 50% RH. They have plotted this stage over here, and the second stage was 30 degree centigrade. At both the point the enthalpies are obtained, and after obtaining the enthalpy, the difference is taken to get the sensible heat transfer, because the mass of air they have mentioned that it is 100 kg. 100 kg of air is mentioned over here. So mass will be multiplied and you will get directly what amount of heat is transferred. If in the coil you are flowing steam, then that heat will be delivered by that steam itself. So they have the in the question they have asked that what amount of steam will be flown if what amount of steam will is flown through the is coil itself when it enters at 100 degree centigrade and leaves at 80 degree centigrade condensate, means water. So for that they have obtained the enthalpy of 100 degree centigrade steam, and later the 80 degree centigrade water. The difference is used, and this is divided in the net heat gain, that is 2050. The net heat gain we have already obtained. It is divided, and the mass of the steam per second is obtained over here. If you go through the one paper also that I have taken from the RGPV's online site, It is of June 17 paper. You can see over here that the question is being asked that what is sensible heating process. Sensible heating process is already known to you, that how this process is being taken place and how it is being shown on the psychrometric chart also. Besides this, you have to write about the sensible heat factor as well as the bypass factor for sensible heating if it come in the question paper itself in the final examination. For cooling and dehumidification process, they have asked what the cooling and dehumidification process is. I will discuss the second process later on. And one case they have asked, this is a simple case. At a place, the barometric reading is 680 mm Hg. You can get in the psychrometric chart itself. And dry bulb temperature is 35 and wet bulb is 25. When two data are given to you simultaneously, here they have given three data. I don't know why they are given three data. Only two data are sufficient to get a point, dry bulb 35 and wet bulb 25. It means in the psychrometric chart, you have to mention what dry bulb 35 and wet bulb 25. Dry bulb 35 you can directly get. You have to draw a vertical line from this. And wet bulb 25 means when it will touch this line, you will get a point. At this point, a specific point, they want the humidity or enthalpy or relative humidity, whatever data they want. You can directly get those data from here itself. I don't know why they have asked this question, because you have to just simply locate the point, and for this question you have to just simply locate the point and obtain the data itself. Now moving to the another case. The sensible cooling I have already discussed, just opposite to this process. Initially we are going in this direction for heating. You have to move in this direction for cooling itself. Now the third process is the humidification and dehumidification. I have told you that in the psychrometric chart, if you want to increase the humidity used to get increased from 0.02 means 2 gram to 26 gram. At the last, they have not mentioned over here. It means for humidification process, you have to move in upward direction, and for dehumidification process, you have to move in downward direction. If you are doing this thing only, you are not changing the temperature, means you are not changing the temperature of the air. This is shown to over here also. That means if you are removing or adding the moisture, humidification and dehumidification. By adding the moisture, you are moving vertically upwards. You have changed the moisture from W1 to W2, specific humidity has changed. And if you are dehumidifying, then you have to move from upward to downwards. And the humidity is changed from W1 to W2. Means humidity is reduced. It is being reduced in this case. Now we are moving with simultaneous operation of cooling and dehumidification simultaneously, because this is required in our summer air conditioners. Because what used to happen in summer air conditioner, for comfort condition, we want that air should be cooled. The cooling should be there, means air should be cooled. We have to move in this direction in the psychrometric chart, because here the temperature of 46 is mentioned and at last -6 is mentioned in the psychrometric chart. We want to move in this direction. Specific psychrometric chart you are using, the writer is RS Kurmi. In our chart, the range would have been different, but almost the answer are same. We are moving in the this direction. They have already moved, because the initial point was having this temperature D1 and the final point is having a lower temperature TD2, means they are cooling. But what they are doing beside cooling, they are dehumidifying also, means humidity has lowered down. It was initially W1 and now it is W2, means it has gone down. We have done simultaneous two processes. If we move like this diagonally in the psychrometric chart, in this case, a right angle triangle is drawn to illustrate it, that how this process has taken place, because a certain portion is called latent heat because temperature don't change, and the certain portion is called sensible heat because temperature change. And addition of both sensible heat plus latent heat will give you the total heat. Means total heat is H1 minus H2. Total heat we will obtain H1 minus H2. You will get over here. That's why right angle to triangle is drawn over here, means air will enter at 1, leave at 2, and the fourth, what they have mentioned is the temperature of the apparatus. This fourth one is the apparatus dew point temperature, and air used to directly get in contact with fourth, means coil, but final temperature is 2, what we are getting. The similar thing is shown over here also, that how this process is accomplished and how this process takes place. Now the next process is cooling and adiabatic humidification, means we are cooling, but instead of dehumidification we are humidifying, means increasing the humidity. Cooling, you all know that we have to move from this direction to this direction because the psychrometric chart we are using is having a temperature of 46 over here and the last temperature over here is minus 6. You can see the psychrometric chart. So we have to move in this direction, means horizontally in this direction. You can directly see that at initial point the temperature was higher, first point, and at a second point, the exit, the temperature is lower, means they have cooled. This is also mentioned also that they are cooling. And dehumidified also means you are moving upward. Initially the humidity was less, now humidity is more. The term adiabatic is being used over here because when we move along the wet bulb temperature line or enthalpy line, there is no heat exchange takes place. This can be explained to you through a psychrometric chart itself. In the psychrometric chart, you can see there are lines directly from the enthalpy. These lines are common for enthalpy as well as wet bulb temperature. When we move, when two points are directly on this line itself, means first point is here and second point is here, you have cooled the temperature, means initially the temperature was over here, it is somewhat 32. It is somewhat 32 initially it was, and the final temperature what you are getting is, final temperature what you are getting is between 20 and 25. You have cooled it. You have cooled in this process. The cooling process is done in this process, and you have humidified also in this process. But when we move along this line when we move, or any of this line we move, the enthalpy remains same, because at the first point also a same enthalpy will get, it is 64 or 65, and second point also you will get the same enthalpy. So no enthalpy change will be there, and without change, this is called no heat transfer process takes place. When no heat transfer process takes place, then it is called adiabatic process. That's why they have mentioned over here, then when we move along this line, this inclined line, you will get the same enthalpy, that is H1 for one process equal to H2. Same enthalpy we are getting, that's why it is called the isoenthalpic process. Now the humidification process can be done by two ways. When the air enters, either the water is sprayed over it, by spraying the water, some water goes with the air by evaporation, and for this makeup water is pumped again. And again, another process is there, cooling by water injection also, means instead of spraying the water, means get evaporated directly and enter into the inlet air, and the exit air get humidified. This is being shown by a particular inclined line. This inclined line is shown to you also because when we move to inclined line, the wet bulb temperature, means what wet bulb temperature was at 1, will remain at 2 also, because we know that wet bulb temperature lines are inclined lines, and the enthalpy at 1 and 2 also will remain same. Now hereafter, after the fourth process, remaining 5 processes are also left. We will cover up these processes in my next lecture, means tomorrow we will cover it, and we will go through the numericals also on this.